Chris will have his inaugural report coming up. And Chris, I understand it's something about, well, a religious... Well, you describe it. What is it?
Well, it's non-Christians given special consideration for teaching positions in Michigan. And I was reading this story, and initially it just says that, you know, people of non-Christian faith will be given an equal chance along with everyone else. And I thought, okay, that's perfectly fine. And but as it developed, there's actually a provision in the new law that says special consideration will be given to those of non-Christian faith, which means whether you're an atheist or a Buddhist or a Hindu or a Muslim or whatever, you will, it's essentially the affirmative action for religion.
So let me share with this, and this is the story I guess we're finding from the Mackinac Center about this, and it's you're saying special consideration in the union teacher contract. So that is the teachers who are non-Christian. It's an affirmative action to reach out to find more non-Christian teachers. Is that what this is?
Right. It seems pretty bizarre because it says given all these things start out, if two applicants have the exact same level of skill, the one in this case who is a non-Christian will be given preference over the Christian candidate.
So it's like a new protected class in a sense. It's the way the affirmative action would traditionally work to find people who are Hispanic or blacks to like right. And so this is like, well, we're going to reach across religious lines. This is sort of a new way to apply affirmative action.
Right. Yeah. And I would point out also that, you know, I've been reading a lot of stories on this today, and a lot of them try to paint it as, you know, the big bad atheists are coming and no Christians need apply and things like that. But of course, the reality is there are still states in the U.S. where atheists can't hold public office. You know, this vicious 9% of the all Americans who don't believe in God aren't really...
Well, when you say can't hold, you mean the people don't vote. That's just the voting
trends. No, they're not allowed to hold public office if they're atheists.
By law?
By law.
Where?
In several cities and states across America.
All right. Well, we'll look for a follow-up report on that. Ben, what do you think when you see a story about, I don't know, affirmative action outreach to non-Christian teachers?
Well, apart from the whole constitutional issue of a government employer, public school district, asking prospective employees about their religion, outrageous, bizarre. I think there's also another angle in there about weird things you can find in your local union collective bargaining contract. Because nobody ever reads those things, and there's all kinds of crazy provisions in those contracts. And this one, I've seen a lot of them in Colorado, but this one for Michigan seems to take the cake.
I know what you mean. You're right, just asking the question. You'd think they'd get sued for that, like for asking about religion. It'd be like asking, something else about someone's, you know, sexual orientation. That's probably illegal, I would think.